Hey guys, this is Aaron. I want to take a look today at generating a door and window schedule using SketchUp and layout. I have a model here. It's kind of a little model. I got these three units and I'm going to show you kind of how I have it set up, and then we'll go ahead and generate a report to create that schedule. So I have my outliner open over here. You can see I have a bunch of components, a bunch of pieces in this model. The most important part are these three big pieces out here. They're little houses, cabana kind of things. And each of these, if I expand the outliner, you can see have a bunch of doors and windows in them. So I'm gonna go ahead and drill into one of these. I'm gonna open up the component for this center unit, and I'm gonna pick on one of these pieces. So right here, first one here is a door. So over here I can look and I can see I have a definition name. This is called glass door, and this specific instance is called D1. Down here under the advanced attributes, which you can get to by clicking a little plus if it's not already expanded, I have my advanced attribute information: price, size, URL, owner status, and then my IFC type if I want to define that. For this particular thing that I'm exporting, just the door and window schedule, all I've populated is the size. So this is a 3068 door. I've done that for all the doors and windows in each of these units. An important thing to note is that that instance is actually what's going to generate the label. And for most of these, it's going to be the same. So the same window repeats, this small window repeats throughout, and it's called W4 wherever it's used. You can see that. The door, for example, is the same component from one of these units to the next, but you can see it's reversed. So in this one right here, I have it selected, it's called D1. If I come into this component over here, select the same door, it's the same definition, it's glass door, but the instance name is changed to D2 because it's going to be an opposite swing from this component over here. So the component is what SketchUp calls it, the instance is what I want to call it on my output. All right, so that all looks pretty good. I have that information in there that I'm going to want to pull for my schedule. The other thing I'm going to look at now is my scenes. Just to point out, I have two scenes. One is a section cut, looking down from above, cut through. The other is just this kind of three-quarter view. I'm just pointing this out because when we hop into layout, I'm going to actually reference those scenes, and we're going to create our output from those two scenes. So now that this model is all set, ready to go, I'm going to go ahead and generate the report. Generate report is what's going to allow me to create my schedule. So I'm going to hit generate report, and I'm going to create a brand new template. So I'm just going to hit create new template. First thing I want to choose is my filter. How do I want to choose which components I report upon? A couple options here. First is selection. Do I want to do the entire model or just what's picked? I'm going to do the entire model because I set my model up to take advantage of nesting over here. Nesting is what level in the outliner the things you want to report are on. So if I look at my outliner right here, the top level is my entire model. Level number two is these pieces, these barbecue, bench, chair, fire pit, table, all that stuff, plus the three buildings. Level three is my doors and windows. You can see I intentionally set up my outliner so that I would have these pieces in this hierarchy. So I can come in here and I can say only report upon components in level three. So that's going to only get these doors and windows. Now, if you didn't set your model up that way, you have things in and out of different levels or something like that, or you have everything in the same level that you can't report upon a single level, that's fine. Then you just want to use current selection and go through and pick the items you want to report upon. It's pretty easy when you have the outliner. You can just kind of scroll down and pick the doors and windows out of the component list. All right, now I'm going to choose how do I want to filter. I actually want to filter by the entity name. That's this label. It's not the definition name. Definition name is this over here. I don't want to put that in. I want to get the entity name. That's going to consolidate all the items that are the same into one line on my output. I'll put a couple other things in here. I'm going to say I want to know the total quantities, and I want to put in the size. That's right. I'm going to put both those in there, and looks good. I'm going to save that report, and I'm going to run that report. All right, so that gives us a list of here's the entity, here's how many there are in the entire job, and then the size. That looks good. I'm going to download that file. I'm going to save that as my schedule. Good to hear. And I can go ahead and close this then. Now I'm going to go ahead and hit save. I don't think I made any changes, but before I generate my layout output, I want to hit save and send to layout. Layout's going to open up with my default template and my current scene showing up in the window. That looks good, but I want to change my scenes to that section cut. That's going to give me that top-down view where I can actually see the doors and windows. That looks pretty good. I'm going to scoot that over, and I'm going to come in here and insert my schedule. All right, that comes in as a new table, and here I have entity name, the items, quantity, and size. This is all editable at this point. At this point, it's just a table, so I can come in here and I can say label if I don't want it to say entity name, for example. That's easy to do. Next thing I'm going to do is label the doors and windows. So I'm going to go ahead and grab one of these, and I'm going to click on this front door and put it up here, slide it over, and now I have an option of choosing what do I want to put in here. So I can choose my different levels. I'm going to choose on the D2 level to put in the component instance. I could also put in like the size if I wanted to call that out. In this case, I just want to put the D2 in, so I'm just going to click out. Here's another window. Click there. And the default is going to use whatever it used last time, so it's going to use that W2 in this case. So I can come around here and I can click all of these to put them in. Great way, easy way to create that. It corresponds to this section right here. And I'm going to go, just for fun, make a copy of this. I'm going to shrink it down. And I'm going to add my model from the other scene. So here's my my scene 2. Because the cool thing is, these labels will correspond to any of the model. So here I have another copy of the model, and some of these windows that I can't see this window that's up here, this L-shaped window, because it's above the section cut, but I can call it out on this one. And those labels, again, correspond to the same schedule because I'm pulling the information off of the exact same model. So there you go. Pretty quick and easy way to create a schedule, door and window schedule, and labels using SketchUp and layout with Generate Report and Advanced Attributes. Thank you.